gravity, mine was. And once I felt my rhythm, and I felt that I could throw a right hand and twist it the last second, similar to Ali when he threw the punch, and I kept watching that over and over. So it became something in my brain. Well, Ali threw the phantom punch with Liston, I turned it. So when I kept turning my fist at the end, I said, it's over now. I started clicking them, champ.
Shane, in all your years in boxing, you ever have an opportunity to meet Ali or spend time with him?
Yep, I did, champ.
What was that like? Tell me about that. Because I only got to see him when he wasn't talking anymore. He was honored in L.A. And I could just, like, walk by him. Couldn't even shake his hand because he had to have people help him. But you got maybe to see him when he was still doing the magic tricks or the jokesters and stuff, the jokes.
I met Ali when I was 20 years old. Yep. And I'm going to keep it real, right? So I went to meet him. I couldn't believe it. I was 19. I was like 19, to be honest, 19, 20 years old, something like that. When the first time I met him, and I went up to him, and he could talk at the time. People don't know that. Like, you know, it got worse, I'm sure, but he could talk at the time. Yeah, RIP to the champ. And he said to me, he said, if I fought you, I'll call you pretty lady. I said, what? I ain't say it like that. I said, what, champ? I said, what, champ? He said, come in. I came close. He said, if I fought you, I'd name you pretty lady. Because I had the blonde dreadlocks. My face, I turned white. I was quiet. The whole time, I was quiet. My manager at the time, Mike Marley, said, hey, what's wrong? He kept talking to me. I couldn't say nothing. He said, what's wrong? What's happened? I said, Ali said if he fought me, he'd call me pretty lady. I said he would have beat me easily. Because my mind, I would have got mad.
Yeah.
He was the master. And then you got mad, you tried to knock him out. And when you tried to knock him out, what happened? You ran out of gas. And his gas started going up and your gas started going down. Just like Floyd Mayweather. He let you spend your money. He let you punch all out. I said, damn. He would have got me mad. I would have tried to gun him down, and then he would have been laughing, and then he would start turning up, and he'd start running them off on top of my head.
Do you think is Ali the greatest heavyweight of all time, the greatest fighter of all time, or how do you rank the Mount Rushmore boxing 1 through 4, the greatest of all time?
I say Jack Johnson, Muhammad Ali. Then I go Joe Louis, and then I go Mike Tyson, and then I go Lennox Lewis. You know what I'm saying?
That's a big honor for Lennox to be even mentioned with them. That's huge.
No, for sure. And then I go Tyson Fury because of the size and the agility now. Fighters fight different, smart different. You know what I'm saying? They're different. They agility, different moves. But that in that order, to me, Jack Johnson, why? Because to have fought during those times, the period of America, the period of Earth, the world, and to have fought during those times with racial, the first heavyweight black heavyweight champion, they killing blacks at all a high time rate. They Ku Klux Klan meetings, he's showing up with the gun on, with the pistol on him. He going to fight inside an arena with 100,000 screaming white people, and he only with one or two black people. Going up against that and laughing, smiling, waiting to knock the fucking teeth out. Teeth out, gang united all around the world. Knock teeth out. Let's go, champ. So that in itself, he showed you no fear. He went in the arena, 100,000 white people, 200,000. Yeah. Breaking
facts.
Them down.
And they couldn't stop him. They couldn't stop. They had to give him some bullshit charge when he was just living his life. And it got them more mad to see him happy. Nice cars, marry whoever he wanted.
Yeah, they feared him because they seen him and said, damn, he knew he was going to break something. And he would do it at ease. Now, with ease, having fun. Beating you up, having fun. The greatest. So, with that being said, and then Ali, because he also put himself into a position where the whole country was against him for his beliefs. But before that, as a young man, Cassius Clay, and then the young Muhammad Ali, unbelievable. And look, imagine if they didn't take those years away from him, champ. Imagine if they didn't take those years away from him, the 3 years he was clicking. That's when he was at his all-time best. He was clicking, and they took away the prime years. And let me tell you something. It's hard to restart. Look at me, champ. If you look throughout my career, it's been on and off, on and off. You know what I'm saying? And that's why I'm able to still be around, because had I been journeying straight through my whole career, I wouldn't be able to sit here and have a conversation with you. I'd be talking like marbles in my mouth.
It's funny you say that, because I was watching the Muhammad Ali documentary. I happened to be in Moscow. I was visiting the Bupas gym over there. I don't know if you've been there or not. Great gym, great people. And they took me to the premiere of the Muhammad Ali movie. And right before he came back, in the second comeback, you could already hear him slur. You could already see, like, who's letting him fight? It's like, you should not let him get near a ring, and he would have still probably been with us. But unfortunately, the business and...
No, but it's boxing. Let me tell you something. If I would have been straight fighting my whole career, have 30 years, so almost 30 years in 2 years, 28 years, I'd be in a wheelchair, because boxing is unforgiving, especially with the heavyweights. Boys hitting hard, you feel me?
Brothers one hitting punch.
Hard. Yep. One punch, and then I'll be talking crazy. I will be like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm able to keep a conversation because I take breaks. I be taking breaks, champ. You feel me? I gotta find another hustle sometime, because boxing will leave you in a wheelchair and broke. And broke, because you went hard.
And like I said, the fans, like Mike Jones' song, "Now I'm Hot, They're All On Me." But man, when the fans... Look, Shannon, if you did one movie, let's say you started in a movie, they did the new Hulk and you were the Hulk, right?
David Flat Sparks, let's go, champ. Flat Sparks in the house.
What's up, Flat? Champ.